Tai Lopez is one of the most controversial figures on YouTube, as many people love him for his advice to become successful, while many others describe him as a guru scammer selling overpriced content, polluting YouTube with ads. Whether you like him or not, you can't argue that he isn't very good at what he does, as he pioneered the whole YouTube mentorship genre, which has led to countless gurus springing up making millions themselves. Considering this, how much has Tai Lopez made from his ads? Well, starting off, let's take a look at how much he spent on ads. In an H3 podcast, Tai Lopez revealed that his partner and he had spent $600 million on ads.
Now me and my business partner, between the two of us, I've spent $600 million on online advertising. He spent more than me.
And that he specifically spent $25 million to $45 million on YouTube ads.
On YouTube, I probably spent, I would say, 25 to 30, maybe 45 million bucks.
Wow, really? Like,
let's estimate right in the middle, saying that he spent $35 million on YouTube ads. This podcast was posted on October 4th, 2017, meaning that Tai had only been doing YouTube ads for about 2 years at this point, as his original Here in My Garage video was posted in September of 2015. He has largely backed off from YouTube over the past couple of years, as the marketing space has become extremely crowded, especially with the rise of Amazon FBA mentors, who really drove up the CPM, or the cost to advertise, to 1,000 people. Today, you would have to spend about $25 to show your ad to 1,000 people, but before the rise of Amazon FBA, this number was significantly lower. On top of this, Tai Lopez was one of the pioneers in this segment, so ad rates would have been well under $10. But let's assume that his average CPM was $10. This means that by spending $35 million on ads at a $10 CPM, Tai Lopez was able to push 3.5 billion impressions. On YouTube, the average click-through rate for ads is 0.514%. But Tai Lopez is a controversial figure, and to estimate conservatively, let's just say that his click-through rate is only half of the average amount at 0.25%. With 3.5 billion impressions, this would still lead to 8.75 million visits to his website. On Tai's newest course, the Social Media Marketing Agency course, a $700 course, under his affiliate program, he claims that he gets a 4-6% conversion rate. This may be true today, as he has built up a solid audience who really like his product, and thus they are more likely to buy. But when he was starting out, let's estimate his average conversion rate to be less than half of this at 2%. With the 8.75 million visits to his page from ads in the first 2 years, this would have led to 175,000 sales. Tai Lopez's average course sells for about $700 for the first year or so, and then did drop in price. For example, his Bitcoin course started at $700, his credit course started at $700, his investing course started at $600, his Make Money Online course started at $700, his Social Media Marketing Agency course actually started at $1,000, and his Millionaire Mentor course started at $500. So, at an average price of $700, 175 sales would have led to $122.5 million in revenue. Subtracting the $35 million spent on advertising, Tai would have made $87.5 million. The great thing about this business is that there are really no other costs other than advertising. Let's just say he spent another $10 million on editors, web designers, discounts, affiliate programs, and refunds. He would still net over $75 million over the 2-year period, and that's conservative. Tai Lopez may be controversial, but he is one of the best online marketers, and his ads definitely grabbed people's attention. As a result, his click-through rate may have been on par with the average 0.5%, or maybe even higher. And his conversion rate may have always been between 4 and 6%. So, if Tai spent $45 million, had a click-through rate of 0.5%, and a conversion rate of 5%, in that 2-year period, Tai could have netted over $700 million. Obviously, that's absurdly high, and it is very unlikely that he reached that amount. But at the same time, the true amount was likely higher than $75 million as well. The true amount was likely upwards of $200 million, or about $100 million per year. This number would also align with his claim that he has figured out how to make six figures per day. And that's just his course sales from YouTube. What about all of his groups and clubs which provide recurring revenue? He claims that his book club is the largest in the world. And what about the other $575 million worth of advertising? Furthermore, you may have noticed that Tai Lopez doesn't advertise much on YouTube anymore. This is because he has already collected the audience and has all of the emails, so there is no reason for him to spend more on advertising on YouTube. This further reduces his advertising costs, leading to even higher profits. Of course, there is also a lot more competition today, and the initial buzz around his name has largely died out. In fact, he only got 7 million views over the last 12 months on his YouTube channel. To put this in perspective, at his peak, Tai got 98 million views in a single month. Given all of this, where does that leave Tai Lopez? Well, over the first 2 years between 2015 and 2017, he made upwards of $200 million. From 2017 to 2020, it's hard to estimate as he has shifted away from ads to recurring customers and we don't know his stats on that. But I think we'd agree that it is not as high as $100 million a year, as that was largely fueled by his first viral ad. But nonetheless, over his YouTube journey so far, Tai Lopez's company has profited at least a couple hundred million dollars. Probably around $300 to $400 million. So hey, maybe there is something to learn from him after all. If you guys thought this video provided a good analysis of Tai's income, then make sure to drop a like and consider subscribing to see more questions logically answered. But until then, I'm Hari, and I'll see you guys on the next one.